Today, history is being made in Egypt as Egyptians are voting for the first time in elections that are competitive, free and democratic since last year's ousting of longtime ruler and close US ally Hosni Mubarak, who had been in power for 30 years. 50 million Egyptians registered to vote for a president of the republic, and big crowds have assembled at the polling stations. Men and women are in separate lines to vote. One voter expressed his optimism. Speaking in Arabic, he said, "I am here to elect for the first time a president of the republic, a president that will be good and righteous and to make this country wake up." While over in Alexandria, the second biggest city in Egypt, crowds were gathered outside. And inside the polling station, everything was set up with the ballot boxes and voting forms ready for the voters. The chairman of the voting committee said in Arabic, everything was going to plan. He said, "As you can see, everything is well prepared for the electoral process. Fair guarantees to all candidates are being provided by the High Commission for the elections. But I want to say the most significant guarantee for a fair poll is the Egyptian justice and judiciary that does not need to be observed because our souls are monitoring the process. We are neutral and I hope everything passed in the right way." So who are the runners and riders then in the voting race? Well, there's Ahmed Shafiq, a former commander of the Air Force and briefly Prime Minister during February 2011 protests. Amr Moussa, who has served as the Foreign Minister and head of the Arab League. Mohamed Mursi, who heads the Muslim Brotherhood's Freedom and Justice Party. And Abdul Monem Aboul Foute, an independent Islamist candidate. I am Anne Salter, thanks for watching. For the latest news and updates on the historic Egyptian polls, go to our website at ibtimes.co.uk.